The next tool is what we call as Dimitri. Now, Dimitri stands for Deep Magic Information Gathering Tool. It is basically a Unix or GNU Linux command, which is coded in C. Dimitri has the ability to gather as much information as possible about a host. The following is the list of the current features that is provided by Dimitri. It is basically used to perform an internet number whois lookup. So all the whois commands that we have seen so far can be performed in a single setup called Dimitri. We can retrieve a lot of possible data on the uptime time, downtime time, and the system and server data. We can perform a subdomain search on a targeted host. We can perform an email address search on a targeted host. We can also perform a TCP port scan on that host target. So a lot of things can be done with the help of this tool, which is called as Dimitri. Hello viewers, welcome back. In the previous few videos, we have seen how to capture a lot of information from a particular domain. Be it the domain name server's IP address, be it the DNS records, be it the particular vulnerabilities or the particular technologies behind a particular website. So we have seen a lot in the previous few videos. We have seen tools such as Whois Lookup, NS Lookup, and in the last video we have seen about a tool called Netcraft, which is used to create a site report of a particular website or a particular domain. In this video, we are going to learn about a tool called Dimitri. Dimitri stands for Deep Magic Information Gathering Tool. As the name suggests, it is basically used to capture a lot of information, or you can say gather as much information as possible from a particular host. How to make use of Dimitri? Dimitri is basically a Linux implementation, or you can say Unix or GUI Linux based command that you will obviously see inside Kali or any other Linux distribution. So what are the various uses or what are the various features of Dimitri? Dimitri is first of all an open source project. It is used to perform an internet number whois lookup. So we have already seen whois lookup separately, but in this case we will see that Dimitri itself is a framework that consists of whois lookup inbuilt. Similarly, we will be able to retrieve the possible uptime data, system downtime data, and the server data. We will also be able to perform a subdomain level search on a target host. For example, a particular host consists of multiple subdomains. We will not only be able to search the various domains but also subdomains of that particular target host. I will show it to you in our practical. Next up, we will be able to perform an email address search on a particular target host as well. So we can say that Dimitri is nothing but a Swiss tool where it is able to perform a lot of tasks, variety of tasks inside a single framework. So how to make use of it? It's very simple. Simply go to your Linux distribution. In our case, it is Kali. So let me open my Kali machine and let me clear this up for you. Let me type in Dimitri and press enter. These are the various options available for Dimitri. As you can see, minus O is nothing but save your output to a particular text file. So whatever results you fetch out of your operation, those will be stored inside an output file, right? Similarly, minus I is nothing but the IP address of the host on which you want to perform the whois lookup. Similarly, minus W is nothing but the domain name of a host on which you would like to perform the whois lookup. In some cases, you might be having the IP address of the host. In some cases, you might not have the direct IP address, but you might have the domain name of that host. So in that case, we'll be making use of minus W. So let me type Dimitri, and one by one, I will type in the options. First one is minus W, that is, I would like to perform a whois lookup on a domain name. Next up, minus I. It will perform a whois lookup on the IP addresses of a host as well. Next up, let me type S. Minus S stands for a search of possible domains. Search for possible domains. For example, if I have multiple subdomains inside a domain, then it will also search the various subdomains associated with my domain. And finally, I will also try to find out some crucial email addresses as well from that particular domain. So it is nothing but Dimitri. So it is nothing but Dimitri space hyphen Vice. Vice stands for perform a whois lookup on the domain name, perform a whois lookup on the IP addresses. So in short, once the domain name is converted into an IP address, it will also perform a host lookup on that IP range as well. And minus S is nothing but search for possible subdomains, and E stands for search for possible email addresses. You can try the remaining options as well, but for the time being, I can stick to this. Followed by minus O. Minus O will basically store all the results of this particular operation into a text file, which you can further analyze later on. So now let me type in a name. For example, let me give it a name called Dimitri result, and let me run this on facebook.com, right? So the very first thing is, the very first option is hyphen W I S E followed by hyphen O, then the particular file name followed by your target host, and press enter. As you can see, the process has begun. It will take few seconds for the process to end. As you can see on top, these are all the Whois lookup outputs. As you can see, it is the host IP resolved for facebook.com, and it was created in 2011, last modified in 2019. Organization name is Facebook Ireland. Fine. And if you scroll down over here, you will come to know the domain name, that is facebook.com. Domain register, registry ID. This is the registry ID for facebook.com. It was registered by registrarsafe.com. Registry expiry is in 2028. Creation date 1997 and so on. If I scroll down below, you will see that these are the informations gathered on the various subdomains of facebook.com. As you can see, www.facebook.com has an IP of this, whereas mobile.facebook.com, that is m.facebook.com, has an IP this. touch.facebook.com has this ID, that is IP address. free.facebook.com is having this IP, and so on. So these are the informations about the 13 possible subdomains for the host facebook.com. If I scroll down below, you will see the email information for facebook.com, the various email IDs associated with facebook.com. They are basically developer feedback at facebook.com, domain at facebook.com, etc. So these are the email IDs using which Facebook actually interacts with their users. So these are the different type of informations. These are the different type of data that you can gather from a particular website. If I scroll up, you will be able to see that at this point of time, I have used only four options, minus W, minus I, minus S, and minus E. You can use the other options also to perform TCP port scan or read the banner information from a particular target host. So I hope you enjoyed this particular tool called Dimitri. In the next video, we are going to learn about a very beautiful tool called HTTrack. So stay tuned.